Let's go to South Windsor, Connecticut. Is it South Windsor, sir?
It is. That's the first time you got it right, buddy.
All right. Where Dr. Jay Sutay is standing by. He's the hardest working pediatrician in comedy. Hello, sir.
How are you doing, David?
Well, I have three things I want to talk to you about. Seizures.
Okay.
The seizing of children and taking them from their mothers. And stomach issues. Let's start off with me, because, you know, they're rounding up kids and taking them from their mothers and separating them. It's the issue of our time.
Yeah, or at least this week.
How does that affect David Feldman? So my stomach, I'm sick to my stomach. I turn on the news and I'm sick to my, like, it hurts.
Yeah. Stress will cause more acid to be produced. Makes your blood pressure go up, releases cortisol. Yeah, stress can make you produce more stomach acid. And who isn't stressed nowadays?
So the solution is what?
I would take something like, you know, I've taken Prilosec OTC probably daily for most of my adult life. It helps me decrease the acid, and therefore I can eat Italian sausage as often as I want. So,
but isn't the real solution to impeach Trump and stop eating Italian sausages? You're treating the symptoms.
Well, to impeach Trump, which is a long shot, you might only need some Pepto-Bismol for that.
Is it conceivable that Trump is giving me an ulcer?
It's possible if you're dwelling on it and thinking about it all the time and it's causing you mental anguish, sure. Sure.
And when I watch the news, I have to say to myself, is this me? Is this me looking for something to be angry about or deflect psychological problems onto something in the news? Or is this really bad? Now, there's a part of me that says, you know, I lived through the tail end of Vietnam. I was a sentient being when we were bombing Laos illegally and Cambodia illegally. Millions of kids were killed in our illegal war against Laos. We round up kids all the time and separate them from their parents.
DCF does it all the time.
What's DCF?
Department of Children and Family Services.
This goes on all the time.
Yeah, I mean, but not in the huge numbers that they're talking about where, you know, I'm glad to hear that some of these shelters, these tender, what do they call it? Summer camp, tender summer camp. I don't know. They keep
changing their name. Baby jails.
A lot of them have been done in former Walmarts. So at least the kids are aware of the layout of the stores. So
they're just automatically going to get fat from being in a Walmart. So we know they'll be well fed. Well, we shouldn't make jokes about baby jails.
I don't want to say that when I was a resident, we had babies in cages, but we had babies in cribs where the sides went all the way up to the freaking ceiling and there was no way the kid was climbing out of it. So, you know, safety first, I suppose.
I was going to tell you about my electric baby chairs for the baby jails, but this is ripping babies from their mothers.
From their mother's bosom.
How bad is that?
A lot of these kids have already been somewhat traumatized, you know, because because of the reasons that their family is going through the trouble of coming to this country. They're traumatized, you know, whether it's gang violence or whatever, they've been traumatized, and it's not an easy decision for these people. I mean, we're lumping them all together. We're calling them illegal migrant people, but you know, they come from everywhere, Mexico and a lot of Central America, and they just come up until they get to the border, and it's a chance. They'd rather take a chance getting caught and being separated from their kids than stay where they are. You know, maybe their decision, but a lot of these kids are really young, and you know, I heard about the news person who said wah wah about a
Lewandowski. That was Lewandowski.
Yes, said that about a kid, a 10-year-old with Down syndrome. And you know, these kids are one, they're not with their family. Their caregivers are going to change from day to day. They're at risk of having more issues related to separation of the parents, inattention when they go. They're not being educated. There's no school going on for these kids. And by not having a consistent, caring, loving caregiver, you know, it's going to be not just an issue now, but it can affect them long term. Very few of these kids turn out to be rocket scientists.
not because they're genetically inferior.
Not at all. Right.
It's the environment that they're.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep. And, you know, there are studies that have looked at, you know, kids that have been in orphanages and kids and compared them to kids that were in foster families in a home with a mom and a dad and everything. And it's unbelievable how much better the kids emotionally and cognitively were that were with caregivers and not in a place where there's, you know, 800 other kids who need the very same thing they do. You know, it's tough.
Can you identify future customs officials when they're kids? Can you look at a child and say, in about 20 years, I could see that kid working for ICE?
Not so much custom officials, but I can pretty almost dead on identify future actuaries. So,
but the sociopathic, is that a term, sociopathic?
Sure, yeah.
The enjoyment, the thrill of sadism, does that manifest itself early as a child?
I have seen kids that have been unkind to animals and have done other things like fire setting at ages of 13 and 14 and have gone on to, you know, develop worsening, you know, mental health issues. I've also seen kids that have done that go on to Harvard, so
which allows them to do it on a massive scale,
on a much bigger scale. They can burn the whole country.
Yeah, Henry Kissinger taught at Harvard, so yeah. What do you do when you identify a child who is sadistic? Can it be cured? Empathy can be taught, right? Empathy can be taught.
I don't know. I don't know. For a lot of kids that were trouble at 12 and 13 and 14, I mean, their regular appearances in the police blotter when they're 16, 17, and 18. Sometimes you just get a bad kid, you know? It's not their fault because either they didn't get the right kind of help or this is just what was allowed to go on. But, I mean, the parents a lot of times, I mean, I remember having one family, this goes back about 20, 22 years, the kid was always being harassed by the police and the parents complained that the police seemed to focus in on only him. I said, well, if they were going to put resources into one kid, he's the kid you should keep the resources focused on because he's a bad kid. You know,
born bad. There are some.
I've had two or three that are just born rotten.
Born rotten.
Yep.
And what do you do if you're the parent of such a child?
You go home and you cry in the shower. That's all I can think of.
And what do we do with them? We just wait for them to commit a crime or they go to work for ICE. I guess the point I'm making is.
Or they become police officers.
Yeah. That they find a way to transform it into something that's perceived as positive, but they reveal their character eventually.
Yeah, I mean, and they don't have to, you know, kill animals or murder someone, but, you know, use that as a metaphor for someone that is an aggressive business person and, you know, they're killing other people's businesses and, you know, and they take joy in it. They're not just doing it for financial. They take joy in the disruption that they cause.
So the ICE agents who follow a kid home from school, round up the parents, hear that child crying. We often ask, well, why don't they quit? Why do they do that?
Well, it's their job and jobs are hard to get.
And they enjoy it.
There are some that probably do enjoy it, I would imagine. There are others that probably go home from work exhausted and cry themselves to sleep. So, but again, you know, I have a job as a pediatrician where I use all my strengths and none of my weaknesses except typing. And but I'm not suited to do anything else. You know what I mean? It may be just because I've done it so long, but I look at my skill set and they're very, very limited. So, I mean, I'm able to use my skills in a way that can earn a living. And I'm sure that people who go into being ICE agents, you know, have a skill set that fits that job description.
Okay.
And some just need to bring home a paycheck.
Yeah. Yeah. That whole notion of I'm only following executive orders.
I heard that somewhere before.
I tweeted that.
Yeah, I've heard that same word spoken before.
Yeah, I was only following executive orders. You know, that doesn't really hold water. The truth is, these people wanted to do it. It satisfied an itch.
What about the now turnaround where they're not going to do it anymore? How does again our president parade people out to elaborate on his policy and then just pull the rug out from underneath him the very next day because his media coverage has been bad? There's no soul there. Anybody with a soul would not be doing this.
What happens if you're raised by an abusive parent who just lies all the time? After a while, somebody like Kellyanne Conway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She has daddy issues. I think she was abandoned by her father, and I understand why. So she's got some kind of sick relationship with Donald Trump.
I haven't heard her name in such a long time for some reason, and it was nice. It was a nice holiday.
If you're constantly lied to as a child, then the truth has
no meaning.
It has, and what does that mean if it has no meaning? You just think it's something like vanilla ice cream. I don't like vanilla ice cream. I'm not interested in it. I don't like the truth. I don't care about the truth. It's just not important. And you can live your life that way.
But what's the truth? Is the truth what you hear on TV, or is the truth something that turns out to be the truth a month later when nobody cares anymore?
But the pathology of somebody like Kellyanne Conway, she just lives a life not caring what reality is.
I don't think she's the only one, David.
Yeah, I think you're right on that. Well, before you go, I have Stephen Miller's home phone number, but I'm not going to give it out. Incredibles 2, moviegoers are warned about possible seizures. There was somebody who was getting epileptic seizures a few years back by watching Mary Hart on
Entertainment Tonight. I remember that. I think Seinfeld did something about that with Kramer.
And it's not so funny, it turns out. What are seizures?
It's basically an electrical disruption in the brain, and brain kind of short circuits and can cause, I mean, there's many different kinds of seizures, but the ones they're talking about are grand mal seizures here, where, you know, you have shaking and movement of the arms, legs, eyes roll back, then there's a long recovery, you know, a couple of hour recovery when the seizure finally stops. So we have other seizures that are small ones where the kids just kind of check out for, you know, 10, 15 seconds and then kind of come out of it. And you pick up some of those kids aren't paying attention at school. Well, they're losing 10 to 15 seconds 10 times a day, so they're not following. But the ones that are full-on shaking seizures are pretty obvious.
Is that epilepsy?
Yeah.
So all seizures are epilepsy?
Yep.
Can you manage epilepsy?
Yeah, there are plenty of medications. The trick is to find a good neurologist that can pick the right combination of medications for the person without, you know, giving them so much medication that it zonks them out, because they're heavy duty medications that, you know, affect the electrical impulses in the brain. I had a kid, he's older now. But he actually had he had so many seizures and so many fails on pretty much every medicine you could try that he had a frontal lobectomy, which was where his seizures were located. And the kid hasn't had a seizure since. Sometimes they'll do a separation of brain. There's something in the middle called the corpus callosum that connects the two sides of the brain. And sometimes they cut that so that the signal doesn't get across from one side to the other. And that can have benefits. So, you know, there are also diets that help with seizures. One is called the ketogenic diet, where the kids eat mostly protein and fat, and they build up ketones in their blood, and that's known to help. And, you know, medicinal marijuana works great for seizures. Lorenzo's oil, basically.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. The operation, dear Lord, when was that? I mean, they didn't have that 50 years ago, did they?
No, I don't think so. I've only had three kids in my practice that have had seizure surgery, and all three have been successful. So, you know, going from having seizures every day or you know, multiple days a week to having none is incredible. Speaking of the Incredibles.
Yeah. And so what is it about Mary Hart? I'm not making a joke. What is it about Mary Hart or Incredibles 2 that could spark a seizure?
Well, with the Incredibles, there's I guess, a couple of scenes where there is flashing lights, and people can have a seizure initiated by photosensitivity, having certain impulses sent to the brain, and it can cause a full-blown seizure. Certain sequences of light, certain smells can trigger seizures. So, yeah, so this person, I think he's a grown man, not a pediatric age kid, but 27 years old, had a epileptic grand mal seizure during The Incredibles.
Hmm. Before you go, you live in South Windsor, beautiful Connecticut. You walk outside. It's glorious, right?
It's not a bad looking place today. This weather has been very nice. I went to Block Island last week. That was beautiful as well. I wanted to ask you a question. Did you see, I think I might have sent you an article on it, that alimony is not going to be tax deductible, alimony payments as of January 1st in Trump's little tax thing? Did you see that?
Yes, I did. And I'm not going to comment on that.
All right.
But you can comment on it.
You know, I just think that it's good that I'm already divorced, but that has to give, you know, guys that are going to have their divorce settled at the end of the year not wanting it to be after January 1st or there's no tax deduction, and women wanting to drag their feet till after January 1st because their alimony payments that they get aren't going to be taxable. This is effed up stuff, buddy.
Well, wait a second. I understand that a woman who receives alimony is taxed.
Not anymore.
They flipped it?
They're not going to be taxed, and the guys aren't going to be able to deduct their alimony from their income tax.
It's
a double whammy. Double whammy.
Hang on. Prilosec, you say?
Yes, Prilosec for your upset tummy. For your upset tummy, I want you to do that.
And this is Trump who did this?
This is in the tax reform bill that everybody is now a victim of, because they're going to be doing, standard deductions, so that we're not going to be able to individually list our deductions from our taxes. It's going to be flat deductions, I guess. So
explain this to me. So they passed a law, as I understood it, if a woman or a man is receiving alimony, that's considered income and they have to pay taxes on it. The person providing the alimony, the human being who is responsible and gets a job and is grateful that the person receiving the alimony had created a home for that person, so that person could go out and earn a living. I've lost my train of thought, but the person who pays the alimony could deduct it
dollar for dollar. So,
now he or she,
right? It could be a she.
Could be a she. Can't do that anymore.
That is what I understand. I sent you an article, which I'm looking for on my computer, but I can't seem to find it.
They get to deduct that.
Yeah.
Hmm. Interesting.
So, no, they and from what I understand, when I find the article, I'll send it to you. It's like if you're paying X amount of dollars, and they say, well, don't worry, you're going to make some of it back. You'll get to keep more of your money because you can deduct it. So you get, you know, conned into paying $6,000 a month thinking it's going to be miraculous. And then you send all that money over to the leech, as you said, and they don't have to get taxed on it, which is like an extra 20% they're getting because they don't have to shell it out. So I guess the lesson is, guys, if you're getting divorced, get it done before December 31st, 2018. And look into this. I only mention this because I nobody's talking about this. This is,
but
you know,
but this is a Republican tax cut. It's supposed to be, men are supposed to be rewarded.
That's right. I thought Trump, if anybody was going to be on the side of the divorced male man person paying alimony, I thought it was one goddamn thing I could count on him for.
Well, that's assuming that the person paying alimony is always a man.
Well, that's true, too. I'm thinking about myself, David, and you as well.
So Prilosec, where do you get Prilosec?
Prilosec OTC. It's over the counter. It's you got Prevacid, Prilosec, and Nexium, which are all over the counter. Pick one and eat sausage.
Well, it's Trump. Between the treatment of these kids and this new tax, this new tax law.
Yeah, it is something, though, isn't it?
He's giving me an ulcer. I need to talk to you about the new tax law. Dr. Jay Sutay is the hardest working pediatrician in comedy because
Because I say so.
And because alimony is no longer tax deductible.
No, for people that are already divorced, do not panic. The rules continue, whatever is your settlement. But if you get divorced after January 1st of 2019.
Well,
then that's an issue. That's why I said, it's concerning for people that it's just not talked about and people should know.
So you can be grandfathered in.
You are grandfathered in if you have previously had your settlement. So you get grandfathered in.
Ah.
So we have no problem.
Oh, okay. Stay on the line for 1 second, sir.
All righty.
Thank you.